right here. Welcome to the show. It is Living and the segment is one-on-one, seated right here at the Cupcake Cement rooftop. You can come chill and dine if you want to, but today I'm having a one-on-one with a beauty queen. She's called Sandra Neema, and she's from the western side, that is Kisoro. She's currently a student at Kampala University studying computer science. She's not a winner for the pageant that is Miss Uganda 2018, but she won Miss Photogenic and Miss Talent. Welcome to the show, my dear.
Thank you. That was an amazing intro.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I try. So, we get into it because you're a beauty queen, you understand?
Yeah.
How did you get into this pageant, 2018? Wow, Miss Uganda.
It all started with I was so much, at the beginning, I wasn't like, I'm not this type of girl, can't do this, what. So I was like, why did I go for this? Because I wanted to be part of something that is life-changing. So one morning, I'm like, you know what? I told my friends, I'm like, you know what? I want to go for Miss Uganda. They're like, you know, you don't look that kind of a person. Like, you're not that kind of a person. Like, you're just not. So I was like, you know what? I mean, people think I can't do this. And so I decided, I was like, you know what? Let me just do this to prove people wrong and to also, you know, change my life, to be part of something life-changing. So that's why.
And then, boom, you entered the pageant.
Yeah, and then boom, I'm auditioning. And then they're like, oh, okay, good.
First of all, I know you're 22 years old. You're a very young, talented young girl.
Thank you.
Because you won Miss Talent. Which talent was that?
I was actually the MC. I didn't see it coming. I never saw it coming.
You're the MC?
Yes. We had a talent night. Uh-huh. There's a talent night they have during the competition. The contestants have to portray their talents. There's dancing, there's acting and all that. So my talent was to host the whole event.
Wow.
So that's what I did. So actually, I never saw it coming. It was really so
overwhelming. You know, most times people have the misconception that when you are beautiful, you don't have brains.
Right.
You know, you're not smart enough. So let's first break it down. What is beauty? How do you define as beauty? Is it just walking, having a pretty face and being skinny? Or there's more to beauty? Because there's the misconception of, she's pretty, she doesn't have a head on her shoulder.
I definitely believe beauty is a whole package of everything. It's not just about having a beautiful face or a pretty face. No, it's about what you have in your head, what you have in your heart, what you can do for the community, how you're changing your community, how you're changing the society around you. So that's what I believe in beauty, because there are so many people who are doing so well, but you know what the world sees, like they're like, oh no, she's not that pretty, but what they are doing is actually what makes it beautiful. That's what makes them beautiful.
Why, you know, it's a question I have to pose. Why is it that people who are short like me and fat like me cannot be beauty pageant queens? It's just unfair. There's a misconception. And secondly, girl, are you really that skinny, or do you like diet to maintain that? Because I swear, if you touch her, this
oh my god,
you're so small.
No. Beauty pageants are not about skinny girls. Because as we can see, there were actually girls who are like relatively bigger than me. I'm just, I don't know, I was born like this because I have a small sister who is actually, she's fatter than you.
Oh.
So like, it's not.
I'm fat.
No. Oh my God, no, that came out.
Calm, no, it's okay. I'm just meaty.
Yeah. No, you're a whole meal. Like, it's just a whole meal. You know, something like that. But, you know, beauty pageants are not all about skinny girls or anything. It was actually a good example in Miss Uganda because there are girls who are, I would say, like plus size models. Mm. You know, they give them a chance to be part of it. It's not about how you look, your height. No. It's just.
So it's a coincidence that most times in the pageant, it's 6 foot plus, maybe two or something, that wins.
I would say that is like the most, I don't know, like maybe from the beginning, the appropriate height they set. Because, you know, that's, I believe that was one thing. Because right now there's the Miss World. She's not that tall. She's not that, you know, like you would see, you're like, oh, this is a real beauty queen.
Have you participated in any other pageants apart from Miss Uganda?
Well, when I was in senior three, I was in Horizon, St. Lawrence. I participated in the Kadanke, the Wakadanke pageants.
So you've so never it really was, been in a professional pageant?
No.
This is
no.
your first time?
Yeah, so I won on behalf of Horizon, but I never got the chance to go to the finals. So that's why, yeah, it's one
so
of
now
the
let's
reasons.
Talk about the fact that, you know, most times also the industry that you put yourself in, I have to say, because you never know. I'm going to ask you what you benefited from it, but like Miss World, most times, or Miss Uganda, they are models, you understand, and they expose their skin, they put on bikinis. How comfortable are your parents seeing you in a bikini?
I would say I'm really so lucky and so glad. My parents were supportive. They're wow. really, really supportive. So I think it starts with their understanding, because they saw, they were like, you're really passionate about this and you want to do it and you can do it, so why not just go for it instead of us, you know, caging you into doing something that you're not comfortable with and you will not even be successful maybe. So that's how it was.
So any benefits, because you didn't win, but you've got two big, you know, medals, that is Miss you winning Miss Talent and, you know, photogenic.
Yeah.
What other benefits have you gotten from Miss Uganda 2018?
A lot. It has changed my life in a tremendous way. Oh my God, I don't know. I've learned so much. I've got so exposed. Like, my life really changed a lot. I used to be this person, like, I wasn't really out there. I didn't see myself doing something, but just the fact that it was a competition and I was like, you know what, I have to go for this. There were so many stereotypes that, you know, actually, they told me that I was short.
Really?
I was actually among the short girls there.
Then I'm so, a midget.
Right. No.
No, I'm playing with
no.
you.
No, you know, like, when I entered, I actually realized there were taller girls, and I'm like, oh, okay, wow. It was crazy. But then, you know, people are looking at me, and they're like, oh, yeah, you're good, but, you know, you're not that tall. So that really gave me a reason of, like, you know what, I have so many people to prove wrong. Like,
yeah.
Let me just push through and... You know.
Any endorsement deals you've gotten, or we should be hoping
yes,
for that?
Yes, definitely. I won a contract with Talent Africa. It's going to be managing me. I'm among the lucky people in Uganda. It's managing Zari, the boss lady, and Anita Fabiola. So I'm the third person.
Oh,
it's amazing. It's. I'm so honored. I really give thanks
so
to
God. So are you going to continue? Because you're currently in Kampala University doing
yes.
computer science. Are you going to continue with your studies, or are you going to put that aside and try to strut the runway?
No, not at all. I was actually so lucky, because all this, the competition ran through when I was off SEM. So I was so blessed. I ended, I was still off SEM. And right now I'm starting my school. So yeah, I'm going to do both of them at once, because I can do it.
That easy? Isn't
yeah, girl.
So you're going to...
No, it's not that easy, but, you know, it's challenging, and I want something that is challenging. So yeah.
You're quite very young. I should even be asking you, do you have a boyfriend? Ever since because I know now people know you. Now you're in Talent Africa. People are seeing you. You're all pretty and everything.
Oh my God.
People
oh
must
my
be.
God.
And men, this is here.
Mm-hmm.
Eh?
Okay,
don't men
okay.
disturb you now.
All right.
Do you have a boyfriend? Isn't he insecure about you now?
Well, you know.
No, I don't know. That's why I need to know.
Okay, yeah. Yes, I do have someone. I'm seeing someone. We are good friends. You're not really.
No, that's too hard. No, don't do this.
Oh, my God.
You know what? You know what Spice Diana said? She said that she is in a relationship,
mm-hmm.
but she's not sure if she's seeing someone.
Oh, boy.
What does that mean? What does that mean?
Oh,
you're either
gosh.
In a relationship or you're not. You understand? Eh?
Well, I'm in a relationship.
Ah, okay. So how is this going? Don't men hit on you?
Yeah.
Even before that, but now it's more. Now
yeah, definitely, because of the exposure and all
yeah.
that. Yeah, yeah. People do come and they approach me.
No,
they're like, "Yo, what's up?" What?
I am putting this
definitely.
Out there.
Yeah, the temptations are there, but you know, it's when you're
Mama
focused,
you
it
right,
really
huh?
helps. Thank you so much. Yeah. Mama real showed me like, girl, just sit down. You're gonna get it all. Don't rush. Don't do anything.
And then you know, people don't like to talk about this, but when you get into the fame, or you get into, you know, you become some big thing in Uganda, which I see, I'm very sure you're going to be farther than what you are right now. Your friends, you know, they're these friends that you had.
Right.
You understand?
Yeah.
And then there are these new friends.
Right.
You understand? And I even asked Navi when he came on the show, how do you differentiate between the real and the fake? Because now, my friend, there are going to be people who like you. Because
right.
Neema is on TV,
because
she's doing that. You understand? How do you differentiate between the real ones and the fake ones?
But, you know, it's actually pretty clear, because obviously there are those friends you have, like I had before getting into the pageant. So I was running, I was telling, oh, vote for me, what, you know, and there's those people I've taken so long without talking to, and then they're like, they just pop up and they're there. So you always know there are people you've like started from way back that have been talking to you, like maybe not every day, but they do get some time and they're like, oh, hi, how are you doing? And then those are the people who are like, they cut you out.
Yeah.
And then out of the blue, just because I'm here, I'm now on TV, and then they're like, oh, hi, what's up? I've seen you. You know, that's it. But it's not always like they're really bad. I mean, sometimes people are busy and all that.
That's true.
Yeah,
can't maintain very friends. We don't need that.
Yeah.
Anyway, when we come back, we've talked about how, you know, beauty is this and beauty is that. We'll be talking about how it has not only benefited you, but the nation. What have you, are there any projects you've worked on? Because so many beauty queens, you know, do these things of like, I'm going to run a project here. I'm going to help people fight this and do this, improve the nation. We'll be right back.